Okay, so over a year ago, I traveled to the Philippines for a month to create a beautiful cinematic video with some friends. But there was a lot of footage and a lot of fun moments that didn't make the cut. So, this is a behind the scenes journey of what went down and a lot of clips you didn't get to see. This isn't meant to be a crazy video with lots of transitions and effects, but rather the raw moments, great times, and good vibes we had. Okay, maybe a few transitions. I can't help myself sometimes. I'm sorry, guys. This story started in Palawan. Well, for me it did anyway. What's going on, everybody? I've just arrived in the Philippines and I'm in Palawan, Puerto Princesa. And like most of you that arrive here, you probably don't know what to do. I have no idea what there is to do in this city. So first things first, look up, see if there's any cool places to go to, hire a motorbike and go explore. So I was going to be in Puerto Princesa for about 3 days. And while I didn't know what there was to do here, I figured I'd use the first day just to ride around on the scooter and see some beautiful beaches. But the next day, I had something really cool planned. So it's 6:45 in the morning and I'm about to head on an underground river tour, which is one of the 7 natural wonders of the world. This underground cave system is supposed to be absolutely spectacular. So I'm super excited to check that out. Okay. So I'm with my new friend Esme.
Hi.
We met on the bus. We're on our way to the underground river, but before we do that, we're gonna jump on a zip line and go over this beautiful beach. That was so hard. So we are at the entrance of the underground river right now, and our tour guides told us some very useful information. Once we're inside, keep your mouth closed because there are bats in there that can probably poop into your mouth if it's open, so don't go.
Keep it shut.
Didn't get pooped on, and no bats pooped in our mouth. So that's a huge plus. So I'm leaving behind Puerto Princesa today to head to a place called Port Barton, which is about a 4-hour van ride away. And this place is supposed to be absolutely incredible, and it's not crazy packed with tourism just yet. So that means I'm gonna get some beaches maybe to myself, which is super cool. Now, when you're heading around the Philippines or island hopping, one of the main things to do is head on a boat tour in that location. The boat tours take you to different islands and you can go snorkeling with fish and sea turtles, and it's just one of the best experiences you can do. We checked out some beaches that had absolutely nobody on them. Then we ended the day on a little sandbank right in the middle of the water, watching the sunset over us and the boat. That is one great way to end the day, let me tell ya. The next day, I hired a scooter again because, you know, that's what I do. And I decided to head to White Beach. Okay, so I'm on my way to White Beach now. My friends that were gonna come with me before, they've chosen to have a nap. So I was gonna go alone, but I met Mia.
Hi.
And now she's coming with me to the White Beach.
So this road's pretty bad. We're gonna just roll the scooter down from here because I don't wanna crash onto all these sharp looking rocks. And I don't wanna hurt my new friend Mia.
Thank you.
Really bad.
So you might remember some of these scenes from the Philippines cinematic video. And if you haven't seen it yet, don't worry, it'll be at the end of this video in one of those click boxes. Anyway, this is Mia. She helped me out with a lot of that video. Together we were able to get some of my most favorite drone shots here in the Philippines. As quickly as I made friends in Port Barton, it was just as quick saying goodbye. As after only a few days, it was time to head to El Nido. Hey, y'all. Okay, so I've just made it to El Nido and the sun is setting on the ocean and it looks absolutely amazing. Behind me, I have Mark Mitchel, who I'm going to be shooting with for the next couple of weeks. And we're just going to be, just me and him, and so we'll meet up with some other people later.
In Cebu.
Yeah. We're going to shoot some cool stuff, but this is amazing. Check that out. Another day, another boat tour with Mark.
We're out here.
We're heading out to the ocean in a sec with ape tours, going to explore some islands. Hopefully we'll see a whale shark, highly unlikely though.
I'm scared of the ocean, but we're going to send it anyway.
Mark here bases his happiness off dog pats.
It's true.
He tries to find as many dogs as possible and give him a pat.
That was my 14th dog.
So
he's trying to get to 100 dogs for the month of December.
He needs at least 50 to be moderately happy. I trust him with my bag, but it's still kind of sketchy. You good, bro?
Yeah.
First stop on the boat tour was this incredible island where the water surrounding it had so many different shades of blue. As we ventured onto the island, we came across this stunning pathway enveloped with long green grass, and the whole place was just covered in beautiful palm trees. If only we had a beautiful girl to model for us, it would have been so perfect. Oh look, a beautiful girl to model for us. What are the chances? Now this is a travel video. All we were missing now was some black ripped jeans and a helicopter. At this point, I was absolutely falling in love with the Philippines. The boat tours were an absolute dream. We got so much food, and it was on this boat tour that I actually got one of my most favorite drone shots in the world. It was where a dog was trying to get from one side of the island to the other, crossing a snake-like sandbar, catching fish along the way. Maybe it's just me, but the Philippines seems to always just have really, really awesome sunsets. Okay, so we've got the whole squad with us today. I've been talking to some of these guys for a while. We finally got the chance to meet up. We got like 7 cameras, 7 drones. So there's gonna be some carnage out there. So we're on our way to a really nice lagoon, but apparently it's super crowded. So before we head there, we're gonna wait it out and play some volleyball. So hopefully when we get there, all the crowds will be gone. Oh my God, what just happened there? Are you okay?
Whoa!
Help! Help! Help!
Can you breathe?
I'm sorry.
We just arrived at the small lagoon and apparently it goes behind the rocks over there. So we're gonna take our drones up and see what's on the other side of those rocks. The water is super blue, this place looks beautiful, so we should get some great footage. There you go, there, Brett.
This is a nice day.
Living the dream. You just soaked my camera. I hope it still works.
Yes, please do.
3, 2, 1.
Oh Jesus!
That was worse than last time.
Hey guys, I think we need to not do this.
Oh, we should probably stop.
Not good. Oh jeez.
You don't know how hard it was to dive off that thing.
Canon or Sony, if you're watching this, can you sponsor us a few more cameras?
We need a few more.
My camera got soaked, his camera got soaked. So if they still work by the end of today, it's an absolute miracle. Left for us to do on this boat tour was to visit a cave that was kind of hidden within a shallow bed of water. It was actually quite dangerous to get to, but it ended up being one of the main shots in my Philippines video.
Probably the coolest thing we've done so far.
The coolest thing we've done so far! I'm sorry, I don't know.
It's a vlog update! I'm driving the boat, I'm pulling this little string. It's doing all the work. Look at this, I'm pulling a string. It's going down to a car motor. And they put me in charge, I don't know why. I feel like I'm the less qualified person on this boat to be driving this boat. But then I'm gonna get a lot of time. Let's go!
It had only been about 10 days so far, and I'd met so many unbelievable people on this journey. A journey that was still far from over. But with each new friend I made along the way, I knew deep down that it wouldn't be our last goodbye.
Where are your other extremities?
That are putting together these bracelets.
He's killing it.
I got you, bro. I got you.
This is Rock. He owns this show.
Are you ready for the zip line?
How's this for service? He's taking us all the way. Hermes.
Well, that's the end of that episode, everybody. I hope you enjoyed my journey through Palawan, but don't worry, there's another episode coming on what happened next, so stay tuned. And if you wanted to see the cinematic video, here it is in the end credits. And if you've already seen it, why not watch it anyway? Gets me more views. Alright, I'm gonna go. See ya.